My name is John Mutuakimiu. I come from Kenya. My problem started sometime in June this year when I started having difficulties in breathing. I could not walk for long. I tried to walk for a few distance, then I started getting tired. I could not walk any longer. After consulting a few doctors here and there, I was referred to a cardiologist in my hometown. I went to the cardiologist, and after some few tests, then I was told that I have an ascending aortic valve which needed a complex surgery. Through a friend, I was introduced to another friend from Bangalore. His name is Rawlings Mathias. He lives in Bangalore. I got his contact, I talked to him, and he introduced me to Manipal Hospital. We made the arrangements, although it was not easy because at that time there was these COVID-19 restrictions and most countries were locked down. So we had to wait until the airspace is opened. Then I made arrangements with Rawlings. He met me at the airport and he brought me to Manipal. At Manipal, I was taken to the international desk where I met a very helpful lady, Lahari, with the team. Lahari has been taking me through different departments for different tests for more than a week until I completed all the tests. Any other department I'm taken, I have to produce the COVID test certificates that I'm negative. There's a lot of, social distancing, sanitization, and all precautions are taken in the hospital. So there is nothing to fear about the COVID here. After completion of the tests, I went and sat with a team of doctors, cardiologists, led by Dr. Devanada.
Ascending aorta means the beginning portion of the aorta was quite enlarged, almost to the tune of 7 centimeters. Along with a leaking aortic valve. Now, only treatment of dealing such complicated problems of aorta is surgery at this moment. There is no other way of dealing this. So we planned an operation around that, and that was executed. What we did in him was, since his aortic valve was so-called trileaflet, but partly damaged, we had to replace that. And the entire aorta, beginning from the root up to the origin or beginning of the vessels to the brain, the entire aorta was replaced with a specialized Dacron tube. Surgery went very well. He recovered very well and is even discharged. Aneurysms of aorta generally develop for various reasons, but in this specific location, so-called ascending aorta, almost 40 to 45% of them could be familial. There are various mutations in the genes which are all involved in the formation of these tissues have been identified. Yes, even Mr. John, we have advised him to go through the aortopathy gene panel, which he wants to get it done a later date. So that if we pick up a mutation, we can even test his siblings and other relatives to pick up those mutations. The complication of this disease, aneurysm, one is dissection. These blood vessels can split spontaneously, causing either instantaneous death in many or probably delayed death in some other patients. The other complication, as the size increases, can rupture, also creating fatality, mainly the death. So these are two important things. Because of very serious nature of these complications, these diseases have to be dealt with very aggressively. Mr. John has gone through this, and several of other patients also in the African countries have visited for this particular problem. These are very serious health issues, unfortunately do not produce so many symptoms until either they're accidentally picked up or we land up in a complication. The important message in this is, since as I said, these diseases do not carry specific symptoms, at least if it is picked up in some, definitely the entire family should be screened. Or if there is an opportunity to look into the mutations in the genes, they should certainly go for it. And today, in expert hands and the right places, treatment probably carries very, very low mortality.
From the way we talked with the doctor, he looked very experienced, and I had a lot of confidence in him. So I chose bundle surgery, and I was operated on 12th of this month, or 12th of November. And in 10 days after the operation, I was on my feet, I could walk, and I was discharged actually from the hospital. Something which even my people from home could not believe. When I tell them that I'm walking, they couldn't believe. As you can see now, I've fully recovered, and I'm even ready to go back to my country. Special thanks go to the whole Manipal Hospital staff, starting from the international lounge, Lahari, and the doctors led by Dr. Devanada, the nurses, and the ITU department, and the nurses at the 10th floor where I went for admission. They were all super. They were good, and I thank them all.